Welcome, Galactic Family. Beloved Masters, as the Supreme Creator increases the flow of the Elixir of Life throughout the Omniverse, it affects all creation. You cannot hide from it. You cannot deny it. Your lifeline to the Source is getting firmer and more compelling all the time. The magnetizing factor is getting more solid, and you are attracting to yourself by increasingly stronger means what you have claimed as your reality. If you believe that you should live in poverty and chaos, these thought forms will be strengthened and expanded in your life. If you have accepted the truth that you are entitled to a life of beauty, joy, and prosperity, that reality will reveal itself to you if you take the proper steps and follow them as outlined in our many messages. Many of you are in a transitional stage where you are feeling disconnected and alone as you strive to adjust to the next level of cosmic vibrational patterns. Mankind is gradually emerging from the restrictive illusion of the lower astral planes, while the expansive and accelerating frequencies of the fourth higher dimension permeate the Earth and all its inhabitants at one level or another. Know that your column of divine light is widening and becoming stronger, so that more and more elixir of life can emanate for you and through you as you saturate your body and radiate into the essence of soul from the Earth. This rarefied energy is decisive for your host planet as this great being struggles to return to internal balance and harmony, as well as to lessen the intensity of the cataclysms on its surface. The highest vibratory frequency is mainly important in the process of purification and return of the auric field, which surrounds your planet, to your original divine model of perfection. As you purify your system of four lower bodies so that they can consistently increase the amount of adamantine particles of light that can magnetize to you and radiate from you, it is a duty and a divine gift to be able to help your beloved planet to evolve as well. The return to harmony and balance begins as a divine discontent within each of you. The higher self begins to increase the amount and raise the frequencies of the light of the Creator that you are receiving. If you heed the call, the consciousness of unity can begin internally, here and now, at this moment. First of all, it is of the utmost importance that you recognize and bring to consciousness all those unbalanced fragments that you created during the many life experiences, those things that control you. Those things that created an emotional and mental prison around you in your auric field. Then they must become aware of these fragments and how they affect their reality. Henceforward, through conscious intention, you must create a burning desire to change and fill those fragments with the transforming energy of love/light. We are always ready and willing to assist you in your positive efforts. But you must ask for it and give us permission so that we can strengthen your resolve to give you the necessary knowledge along with the quickest and best way to accomplish its transformation with ease and grace. In your mind, however, you visualize that you are seeing the Earth from a great ship of light, and together, we, the angelic forces and the multitude of universal beings of light, who represent our Father/Mother God, we are producing the energetic vibratory patterns of the wonderful divine scheme in preparation for humanity's dwelling of the Earth. During the complex stages of preparation, large sentient crystals were implanted deep in the Earth, in strategic places around the planet. A part of every huge crystal rose to the surface of the Earth, like sentinels who radiated energy and information toward the cosmos, as well as functioning as a receiver of divine light, wisdom and power, originating from our Father/Mother God. For many eons, as changes occurred on Earth, in which mountain ranges rose to the heavens, masses of Earth submerged under the waters and continents shifted and changed in form, most of those crystals were scattered and hidden under the waters, in large caves, and many more remained near the surface of the Earth, hidden only by a thin cover of earth or vegetation, waiting for you to discover them and present their gifts and ancient memories. They are the keepers of the Adam seed records of the earth, and you hold the key that will give you access to the wisdom and power of manifestation that lies within them. If you could really see the grid system, the web of life or the connection of all things, you would have a better understanding of the concept of oneness. It is not just Earth that has an intricate grid system. You have streams of light that radiate from you into you, to each other, back and forth among all the people on Earth. Some are stronger, others are weaker, but you are still intrinsically connected to everyone and everything on your planet, and even to this subuniversal expression. This can be impressive and difficult to imagine, but it's true. When we say that you are all one, what does that really mean and how does it happen? It is because there are these streams of light that penetrate and infiltrate all, around and across the earth. Yes, most of these streams of light are very weak, but more and more of these streams of light are becoming stronger and forming a vibration of recognition. There is an echo coming from within, which says, "Yes, I remember. Yeah, I know who you are, and I know we've been together before. I do not know where, but I feel and recognize its vibrations and its energetic signature. You touch my soul and make my heart sing. Your love essence assures me that I am not alone. Welcome to my heart. I ask you to share my journey and allow me to be part of yours as well. Each of you has in your soul essence, your DNA and so many wonderful gifts of the personal divine self, so much magical energy and a vast bank of memory of universal information and stories. All these stories, which are now being told, and the old memories being accessed, do not you realize they were there? Maybe they were not always specifically you in physical form, but sometimes you are a close member of your Alma family. You do not need to personally experience everything that has happened during this great journey all over the universe and on Earth to be part of that or to have in your memory bank, because you have a lifeline, an attachment of soul memory with to their immediate soul family, who creates a bond in which they have the data and the wisdom of their experiences and these are sown in the repository of their memory as well. In the past, you have often tried to stifle or gain power over addictions, your negative habits, and thought patterns. You have resisted them, hated and constantly thought of them, thereby reinforcing their control over their emotions, their minds and their quality of life. Remember, we have said many times, because it is a universal truth, wherever and wherever you focus your attention, you energize and reinforce, positively or negatively. You must release the fragments you have created, loving them and acknowledging that they have served you well. The best and most effective way to achieve this is to send a passionate thought that it is time for them to meet with you, and once again be part of you, in your heart center of solar power, to be filled with the light and become a capable facet of your divine consciousness. Know that everything, on some level, is seeking the light, seeking balance and harmony, seeking to return to what it was in the beginning. Each stage of new awareness or expanded consciousness has its miracles and special benefits, which is to be savored and enjoyed. Each time you release some form of self-limiting and painful thinking, habit or dissonant energies, you are transformed and remove a small or large part of your disguise, which allows you to gradually create a new and empowered person. A new reality opens up for you, through which you gain access to many new concepts as well as new talents, and your sensitivity to the exquisite nuances of the spirit miraculously reveal themselves. You are learning very, very quickly. Often the mind is so expanded that you do not know what to believe in and think you cannot accept or integrate more new information, But we tell you that this is just the beginning. You are becoming spiritual/human adults, considering that in the past you have been functioning as human children in a restrictive three-dimensional reality, feeling as if you are disconnected from God and controlled by the whims of fate and nature. As masters of yourselves and spiritual adults, you are learning that you are citizens of the universe, you are star seeds, warriors of light, and the New Age vanguard. You have flown all over this universe and other universes as well. You have heard for a long time that there has been a quarantine around the Earth, this solar system, and even the galaxy, which has now been broken down, so that it can receive galactic, universal, and universal information. Now we tell you that there was also a filter placed around this universe. This universe, of which we are all part, is one of the newest universes to be created from the essence of the Supreme Creator, and therefore is a universe that lies in the most extreme part of creation. In addition, we were limited in our knowledge of the workings of the Omniverse, as well as the amount of energy of higher vibrational frequency to which we had access. You see, the first universes that were created were the most powerful and closest to perfection, because they circled the great central sun of the Supreme Creator and contained the pure essence of creation. As more and more universes, galaxies and stellar systems, ever expanding and pushing creation beyond the great void and further away from the Supreme Creator, each refraction to density meant that each new creation had less of perfection of all that is. You must realize that we are all very reduced energetic fragments, but still an integral facet of the magnificence of the Supreme Creator. And if we were sent with the command to create in the name of the Creator, because it was his desire to experience more of himself, why should the Creator tell us what to create? We received a blessed divine gift, as co-creators, and so it was with each one of you. You are self-writing gods, and this is not sacrilege, it is a universal truth. You must understand that this is why you are here on Earth, that is who you are. Do not let anyone tell you anything different. Remember, you are also responsible for the creations themselves through the laws of cause and effect. Please understand that this universe was created with the primal life force substance dramatically reduced and diluted. Some call this fallen universe, but we prefer not to call it that. This is a universe that was created specifically so that it could experience duality and polarity. The spectrum of light and shadow was projected with the tranquility point of the Creator's light at its center, and the pendulum of duality was to oscillate only in the positive/negative, male/female, light/shadow, yin/yang energy. You need to understand that some of the creative gods created less than perfection as they also learned to use their rights granted by the Creator. Over time, the pendulum has swung ever more to the dark earth and duality, but has always been balanced with the same amount of the substance of divine light. The duality/polarity of the earth is now in the process of returning to the center, to its appropriate and projected spectrum of light/shadow. There have always been magnificent emissaries of the higher realm scattered throughout this universe, and particularly in this sub-universe, in its galaxy and on Earth, because it is here that the culmination of this divine experience of creation is being represented in its final stages. As we said earlier, the Supreme Creator is now taking an active part in the creative process of the entire Omniverse, and the pure and rarefied energy of the core of his heart is now flowing and affecting each facet from the greatest to the smallest. Creation does not contract, is always expanding, and you have a part to play in this expansion. You are at a great crossroads, my beloved ones. As you go through the process of cleansing and cleansing the multiple facets of yourself, You're leaving behind the energies that created all the pain, suffering, and anguish. Step back for a moment and see these last months as observers. Are you beginning to get the picture of what the grand plan and the ascension refer to? Being aware and being in control are important facets of mastery. If you have worked diligently with the lessons we have given you, you must be well on your way to recovering the many gifts that have brought to Earth as many eons. Each of you is the center of your universe. You, as co-creators, send energy and intention, which in turn creates thought patterns of a certain frequency. These higher frequency vibrations come out of you as energy rays in a sign of the infinite, creating waveforms that are the reflection of your conscious thoughts, intentions and actions. As you learn to remain centered in the heart and centered in the soul, radiating unconditional love and balanced vibrational patterns, your world and your reality gradually change for the better, because you are functioning as trained teachers of co-creation, true divine emissaries of our Father/Mother God and the Supreme Creator. During these times of uncertainty and great change, remember, my beloved warriors of the light, there is nothing to fear, much to gain. Feel the warmth of our sacred breath, as you touch your face, perceive the aura of love in which we surround you. We're close, reach out and touch us. We will respond. You are loved very deeply. I am Archangel Michael.